3, 2, 1, go. All right, what's up guys? Welcome to another crash course. Let's dive right in. So first things first, we need to download our reference. So you can download them by just going to my website, drugfreedave.com. So just drugfreedave.com. So anyway, so just go to my website. Here's all my classes and stuff. Just scroll all the way to the bottom and download this, because we're gonna do this little guy. He's very, very simple. So you can just long press it and save image. So then when you're in Nomad, we wanna bring this reference in as a reference image. So we're just gonna go here, reference image, tap on it, import photos, and you just have to find wherever it downloaded to your iPad. So here it is. So we're just gonna tap on that, add, and then it adds right here. So I'm gonna tap on this open space right here just to get rid of that. And I wanna hit transform. Transform, you can just move this around wherever you want. I think I'm gonna put it here. We're only gonna do this little guy, so it's okay that the rest is cut off. Yeah, we'll put it right here. And then you just tap once and it'll go back to the regular screen. So let's get our canvas set up. As you know, here's a little cube. So if you tap that, you're looking at the very front of your sphere, your mesh, your 3D object. Right now, it's just a sphere. So all that stuff is your mesh, your 3D object. There's lots of words for it, but this is our sphere. I like to change this to a matte cap. You don't really know, the quick thing about a matte cap is it's just an easy way to see it. It disregards like the ambient lighting. It disregards like all that stuff. So it's just like a good way to see your clay when you want to sculpt. So let's do that first. So we'll go to, where is it? I think it's this one, this little lighting thing. Lit PBR is normal, default. We're gonna change to matte cap. And later on, we'll change back when we wanna paint it. So now we have, this is matte cap, it's perfect. There's also a grid. If you look, you see like this grid right here. You can turn this off down here. And if it's not there, you can go here. These are shortcuts. So everything here that's highlighted is down here in the shortcuts. You'll also see me use this a lot, voxel remesh. So if you hit voxel, if I scroll up, you see voxel remesh. So I always use this shortcut. It's the same thing as using voxel remesh up here. If you don't know what that is, that's okay. I'll show you what it is later. It's just how you put stuff together and create one piece out of one or more than one piece, among other things. All right, so let's get started. So first let's delete this sphere. So we're gonna tap here. This is our scene. The scene, this is where we add all our shapes and things like that. Here's our sphere. You can make it go invisible. You can bring it back. You can tap these three dots and you can, there's some options here. You can clone it and then you'll have two. Name it and you can delete it. So we're gonna delete it and then we're gonna add another sphere. This sphere is much smaller in size. You probably didn't notice before, but the other one was really big. This one is really small. And the reason why this is important is because the higher this number is, the more it taxes your system, the more it makes your project heavy. So we're not gonna worry too much about it, but just so you're aware, scene vertices is a very important number. And you just wanna, you don't wanna go up too high. You don't wanna get up into like the millions, because as you sculpt and get things get more intricate and things like that, the number will go up. But just so you know, keep an eye on that number. Don't let it go too high. Okay, so next big thing is the gizmo. So we added this sphere here. See how it's orange, the word sphere? That's because we haven't validated it. So there's a few things you can do if you press here. There's a few options you can do before you validate. There's a few options here that you can do before you validate. So once you validate, then it's officially part of your project and more tools show up. So just remember, when you add any of these shapes, you can move it around a little bit, but you have to validate. And then once you validate, then you can use the tools and things like that. So don't get confused if you add a shape and then you can't do anything. Gotta validate. So now that we're validated, let's go ahead and name this the head. We'll make this the head. So we have our sphere here. We're gonna tap these three dots, name, and this will be the head. Okay, good. It's a good start. So that's the head. So let's actually bring the grid back. And See this red line? That's the horizon line. So if we hit front, it should be like a flat red. And there's another thing, just in case yours, let's tap this little camera. See how we're in perspective? Let's change that to orthographic. It's a lot better to sculpt in orthographic. If you sculpt in perspective, there's just a lot of perspective distortion. So if I made two spheres and one was further back, it would look smaller. And it's like, if it's not supposed to look smaller, you're like, why does this sphere look smaller? And it gets very confusing. So orthographic, rule of thumb, sculpt in orthographic. Also, this red is the horizon line. So let's make that be the floor. I always make this red line. If you hit front, that line is going to be the floor. So I don't like the grid. So let's set up a little platform for him. Scene, add, and we'll do a nice little cylinder. See, this is a cylinder here. And also the gizmo. That's what I meant to say before. So this is the gizmo. This is the gizmo. Sometimes it's in two places. It's a little confusing when you add some shapes because it's grayed out, but it still works. Gizmo just moves everything around. Big is the big ring, orange ring is the size. These arrows are left and right, up and down. Oh, double tap to undo as well. Like if I move it, you can double tap to undo. And these rings are to rotate it. So, you know, you can move it and you have different ways of rotating it, different directions. And these little spheres are to stretch it. So pretty simple. One thing to note, symmetry is very important when you're sculpting. And we're going to use symmetry a lot because he has two arms, two horns. The teeth are going to be the same on both sides. The eyes are going to be the same. So we're going to use a lot of symmetry. So just be careful when you're using the gizmo not to accidentally move this a little bit, because then things can get messed up and you might not notice. So just be careful of that. Two finger tap to undo. So just be careful. Just be mindful. Try not to accidentally move, because if you do that a little bit, it can make it a lot harder later on. Okay, so let's use this little sphere and shrink it like this, but it's too small. So we'll move this. We use this orange ring to make it bigger. Maybe something like that. Maybe shrink it a little bit, hit front again. We'll use this green arrow to bring it down. Let's bring it right to so it's right lined up with that. Then I can get rid of the grid and we have a little platform. Okay, so we haven't validated it. So if you notice here, it's yellow. We can rename it platform. Platform. Okay, it's still yellow. But before we do that, let's kind of round this out. So we'll tap these three dots and we'll just bring this to two. So we'll bring that to two, kind of rounds it out. And I think that's good. So let's hit validate. So now it's validated. We have our platform and we're good. If yours doesn't look like this, if anything you're doing and you see like little blocks, go to this little round thing. It might be smooth shading. If you turn it off, it's going to look like this. And I've turned it off for this specific shape, this specific mesh. So just remember, if it looks weird, if it looks very pixelated, it could be the smooth shading. So I keep mine on auto. Auto is on. Okay, so now we have our floor. Let's go ahead and bring this up. Our body. And you see the floor, the body is like fairly close to the floor. Let's hit front, fairly close. Then he has two little legs here and the head and the thing. So what we're gonna do first is just block this character out. Blocking out just means using shapes, and we're gonna eventually, you kind of mold the shapes to look sort of like this and then we'll join them together. Easy peasy. So this is the body. Let's clone this for the head. So we'll tap our scene. We have the head. Oh no, this is the head. We'll clone it. And let's rename this body. Okay, so we have body and we have head. Let's go to head. And notice we're still using our gizmo, so we're going to move the head up like this. And it looks like it's around the same as the body, actually. So it's not too different. So I think that'll work. There's some more. What are we going to do for that? I think we can do more spheres actually for that. So let's take the head, clone it, and let's name this arms. Hit OK. So now we have arms. But the arms are on the sides, so let's move this one sphere over and this one sphere down. Now let's shrink it with this orange ring, like this. And we'll work out how to make it a little bit later. I'm not sure how I want to shape it, but generally we're going to use the sphere to make the arm. But we want to have it on both sides. So what we want to do is add a mirror. And we haven't moved everything. This is the center line of the project right now. So by default, when you mirror things, they're going to mirror from this side of the project to this side of the project. So just tap this little thing here. This is the symmetry options. So on the project, this is the x-axis. I'm not going to go too much into this because it's kind of confusing. But to make a long story short, this is the x-axis. The x-axis goes down the middle of the project. And that's just the default. So this is always going to be by default. Let's scroll down and turn on show line. Just because I usually keep that on, it'll make it easier. So now when we tap on anything, and you're kind of looking at it, see, if we look at it, you see the symmetry line. And if we were to change it, you see a different symmetry line. So I always keep that on. It's just kind of nice to know what my symmetry is. But when you use a mirror, it's the symmetry of the whole world, the whole project. And right now we're still on the middle. So let's go here, arms, add, and see these repeaters? There's a bunch of them. We're just going to use mirror. See this? This is showing that it's just, it's mirroring this side to this side, or this side to this side. So that's all this is. You don't really have to worry about that. But this is what a mirror does. It just mirrors it on the other side. And anything, like if I was to drag this head into this mirror, then it would do the same thing. But I'm going to undo. So now it's still in the mirror, so I'm going to undo again. And now it's back where it was. So that's a mirror. You can add things in, you can take things out. If I were to take this out, you would just see one arm. So that's a mirror. I'm going to name the mirror arms as well. And you can use these little things to like kind of, it's already nestled, but if you want to just make it smaller, you can do that. And if you want to move these things around, you just long press them. You can move them around, you can nestle them, you know. Sometimes you get to projects and you have like tons of these. So you always want to label things and just keep things organized. Trust me, it is a big help to do that. Okay, so let's see, where are we at? Where are we at now? Oh, the two little feeties too. So let's go ahead and, so arms, let's take the arms. So these are probably going to be spheres as well. So let's clone the arms and rename them feet, or I like to say feeties. So now we're on this feeties, so we just bring this down and we'll just use this to pull them closer together, and we can kind of work it out from there. So he has a very tall body, so now we just have to kind of maneuver him around so we can kind of make him like he looks in the image. So first and foremost, let's do the body. So he kind of has like a, this might be a pill shape actually. Let's see, if we stretch it, we might be able to get away with it being stretched, I think. So something like that might work to stretch out the body. And let's use some tools. So let's use move. So we're using the move tool here. You can see my radius is around 200 something and my intensity is about 50. Something like anything around here, I think will work. Symmetry is very important. When you have symmetry on, then it's going to take the symmetry of this line. So see these two dots? I'm using the move tool. Anything I do here is going to happen to the other side because I have symmetry on. See, if you don't, you'll know really quick. So we want to use symmetry because we just want to make his body symmetrical. So we'll hit front. And you can see that he's kind of straight, like this part is kind of straight. Let's make the radius a little bit bigger. So now let's just try to make the body straight. And you gotta sometimes push and pull, kind of push and pull like both sides. And that's the nice thing about symmetry is you don't have to worry too much about it not looking good, because symmetrical things usually look good. They usually look right. So his body's a little wider too. So you can make this a little bit smaller maybe and just kind of try to stretch out the bottom. So this is like just regular old sculpting, you know what I mean? So we're just trying to make this kind of like, kind of round, you know, shape for his body. So nothing too crazy. I'm gonna make this wider, I think, at the bottom. Maybe at the top too. But one thing you have to keep in mind though is just try to keep this like even. Like don't try to go too much out or too much in. Just try to keep it even and it'll look nicer. And sometimes you can go bigger and it'll be more of a smoother move. But anyway, I think that's pretty good. So you just want to do something like that. So let's go to this side. We have to imagine what his body actually looks like because we can't really see the back. So we just kind of have to imagine what the body looks like. I think there's a little bit more of a belly. So in my head, I'm just going to pull this little belly part out a little bit. Maybe make this a little smaller. And you know, we still have symmetry on, so we know it's going to be symmetrical. We don't have to worry about the other side. We can just worry about the profile. And the profile is just how something looks on the side, like a side view. So I'm thinking something like this. I feel like he would be sort of that shape. And you can plump the belly out a little bit more if you want, something like that. So I think that looks pretty good. Okay, so now we have these spheres on the bottom. So let's sort of make some feet. So we use the gizmo again, and let's kind of stretch these out like this. And they're a little too close. See the space between his legs? So the ones I have now are too close. So I'm going to squish them together. And I think I'm going to pull them like this. I know they're coming out the bottom, but we can always trim these. So I'm not worried about the bottom part of the sphere just yet. Okay, I think that's pretty good. Maybe I'll move them back a little bit. Well, no, I'll keep them in the middle. Maybe I'll even bring them a little... Oops. I accidentally hit this ring, and that's why I hit undo, because I didn't want to like mess with the ring. So just be careful. Sometimes with the gizmo, it's so easy to hit something else. Unfortunately, whoops, see, I'm undoing things, or I'm pressing things by accident, so I'm just going to hit undo and just make sure that I go back. Well, that always happens. But with the gizmo, it's unfortunate that you can't just have the arrows, you know, or just like a little thing where you can press like lock on just this part or just whatever, you know what I mean? Because when you have all this stuff, it's really easy to like accidentally hit something random and then you've messed up your project. Anyway, I'm digressing. So let's make these a little bit. See, there's like a little bit, it kind of comes out and then it kind of goes out here. So we kind of want to match those little details. So we're going to use move again. And we could use symmetry, but we don't really need to. We don't really need it because right now, if we use symmetry, it's going to be, see this one sphere? It's on both sides. So we don't really need it because still whatever I do on this side is going to happen over here because it's in a mirror. So we're going to use move. And we're going to turn off symmetry. So you should just see one dot here. So now I'm just going to stretch this one. I'll maybe make it a little bit smaller. So I'm just going to stretch this foot out like this. And there's some other things we're seeing. Like we're seeing that it's kind of the right size. Like things are, it's looking good. The only difference is the body comes down a little far here. So these are just things that I'm keeping in mind. Like it looks good, but we have to bring the body down a little bit more. Or we'll bring the whole character down a little bit more. Either or, but we have some options. So now let's do the head. So the head, we're using move and we're using symmetry because we want to just shape the head. So if we look at this guy, it's sort of like it's wider here, but doesn't look too difficult. I think we can match that shape. a little bit squarish. So I'm gonna start with there. I'm gonna start pushing down on top, making it kind of squarish. You can move the whole thing up with the gizmo if that's easier. Back to move tool. So now I'm just gonna spread out this lower part of the head and just try to match the image. So maybe something like that looks good. Maybe pull this out a little bit more. I think something like that looks decent. Might be a little bit too small, actually. And the body's very, very wide. So that's another thing. Once we finish kind of blocking these shapes out, then we have to kind of pay attention to, you know, things like that. But I think this is pretty good. We have to kind of guess what the back of the head is. So right now, I don't like that it's... I feel like his head would be out a little bit further, even in the back. So I'm just going to use move tool and just kind of spread out the back too. Maybe move it back this way. Turn it profile and then just sort of work on what I think the back of his head might look like. So maybe something like that. Oop. Wait a minute. Let me look at the top. Okay. I thought that I had forgotten about the symmetry, but I think it's just the bottom part of the head. See how this is? I just want to puff the bottom part out as well. I thought I didn't have symmetry on, but I did, luckily. So this feels pretty good. Let's take a look at the front. Kind of looks like it matches that. Okay, maybe I'll just bring this up a little bit. Maybe I'll bring the chin, the head down a little bit. But yeah, I think that works. I think that works. Okay, so now I'll hit front again. So let's look at the body and just kind of try to match it up a little bit more. So I'll tap on the body and use gizmo. And remember I said before, I'm gonna bring it down a little bit. And I'm actually gonna squash it and bring it down again. Okay, so he's a little shorter now. So we'll see if that works. Let's use the head and bring the head down. I think that works. I think the head might be able to be a little bit, maybe a little wider. Maybe I'll stretch it a little wider, like so. I think that works. Okay. So now he's got his little feet. He also looks like he has like a little tail as well. So let's hit the front. So we have to remember to do his little tail. So let's do his arms. So for the arms, let's use the move tool. Again, we don't need symmetry. The arm is in a mirror, so we don't want symmetry. We just want to kind of flatten it so it looks like what the arm might look like. So I'm just going to use the move tool. And I'm just going to kind of stretch it. So as you see, like I'm literally just stretching this arm, kind of flattening out against the body. I'm going to drag it into where the body goes into the head. And as you can see these arms, they're very thin. So I'm going to thin these arms out a little bit. You might even be able to take the gizmo and squeeze them together to make them thin. So don't forget, you can always use the gizmo. So that looks good, but you see how they kind of curve up? So I think it would look better if the top part is like not so thin, if it's kind of like just kind of normal. I don't know, maybe it would look good thin. I'm gonna push it into the body a little bit. And I think they need to be smaller. And I'm actually gonna use this blue ring to kind of adjust the angle. Okay, and another thing you see with the gizmo, I moved the arm and this gizmo now isn't straight. Let's hit align. And if you hit align, as long as align is on, the gizmo is gonna be straight to your project, meaning this will always be up, this will always be left and right. If you turn it off, it's gonna be aligned with the shape. So as we move the shape, the gizmo moves in conjunction with it. So I'm gonna hit undo, hit align. And the reason why I'm hitting a line is because that just makes it easier if I want to move them straight inside to the body or something like that. So that looks good. So at this point, we see that, let's see, there needs to be a little bit more on the front of him. So I'm going to take move and I'm going to just put it a little bit over his feet. So we're using symmetry and we're using move and we're on the body. Make sure you tap the body. So I'm just going to bring this out a little bit. So I'll just bring this out a little bit, maybe on the sides too. I'll make it a little bit bigger and just kind of bring it down a little bit. Maybe in the back too. Maybe a little bit more for his little butt. Okay. So now we're this looks a little bit closer. See how the body comes down and here's the little feet. And we can even take the feet if you want and you can sort of can move them out a little bit. Something like that. I want to make them a little bit more foot shaped. So I'm going to just kind of pull them. Maybe push in the back. Because the heel probably would show a little bit less. So I'm going to push in the back a little bit. And maybe like spread out the front. Yeah, so something like that. So now let's look at the distance between the foot and the arm. There's way more distance here. So that means I need to bring the arms and probably the body. The body can probably be shorter as well. But let's just do the arms. I was going to do them both because you can take the arms, for example, and the body, and then you can move them both as long as you have them both selected. But I don't think we need to do that. I think let's just take the arms and just move them down to the place kind of where we want them, which is kind of like right there. I'm just gonna skinny this his body up a little bit more, like so. And then I'm actually gonna make the head. I think I want to, let's make sure I'm in the front. Let's make sure I'm looking at the front. Okay, here's the front. Because sometimes I forget which way is front, so just make sure that you tap front so you're looking at the correct direction. Okay, so let's see the head. Matt, that looks, seems like it matches up okay. I'm gonna move the head forward a little bit, like so, and I'm gonna bring it down. The arms actually look like they go into the head, so let's make this a little bit bigger. And I'm just gonna make his cheeks go out a little bit more, like that. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. Maybe we'll move the arms a little bit towards the front. And I think I'm gonna bring the face out a little bit, even like in the back. I'm just gonna bring the face out and maybe down a little bit. So now the arms look like they're kind of going into the head, which is what we want. Okay, so hopefully you're kind of seeing that I slowly just kind of make it look like I just really use the reference. You know what I mean? So you just have to constantly reevaluate the reference. Okay, so next, this is all looking really good. I'm pretty happy with all of this so far. The only thing I want to do is, this is a little bit of a weird shape. And do I want to, let's do this. Let's go ahead and delete these. Let's delete those. Let's go to the arms and then just hit add and sphere. We're just gonna make two new ones. So they're already in the mirror, so we can go ahead and validate them. Use our gizmo. So let's separate them. Use the orange ring to make them smaller. We'll separate them again. And let's squash them this way. And then let's, let's make them a little bit bigger. Let's stretch them out this way too. Let's stretch them out this way. Let's move them forward. Yeah, I think that's a little bit better. I think that's a little bit better. That works better. Let's move them out a little bit from the body. Yeah, I think that's perfect. I think that's better. Yeah, don't ever be afraid to just delete something and start again if you think it'll be easier. This is a much better foot shape, and that'll be great to add those little toes. The only other thing that I might do is kind of, let's take symmetry off and just kind of push this side in a little bit more. There we go. I think that's perfect. Okay, so let's add these little horns. So for the horns, let's go ahead and there's two ways that I would do it. I haven't showed you guys the tube, so let's use the tube tool. So tap tube here. We don't really need snap, so we can turn that off. And let's use path. So now we're just gonna make one horn and then we're gonna clone it for the other one. So with path, you wanna put your stylus down or your Apple Pencil and then drag and you'll see this line. And then you can lift up. So now you can move to another place. And once you put it down and drag, it's gonna add another little node. So then you can lift up. And you can continue to do that as much as you want. But all we need is a simple little horn. So let's hit this green button. And then we have something like this. So now we'll just use these nodes. Like this bottom one, we'll just move it into place kind of where we think that they would be. I think that they would be a little bit off to the back of the head. So let's move this up a little bit. Let's hit spline, B spline. That just makes it nice and curvy. So it's going to be something like this, but let's put him in the general position. So of course, again, position and moving things around, you want to use the gizmo. I'm going to hit left. I feel like they would be here, maybe down a little bit. And I feel like they would be tilted back some. To me, that feels about right. Something like that. Maybe a little bit further up. So something like that looks good. So let's hit tube again over here. So you hit tube, and then we have our options back. So radius is very important. The radius is the width of our tube. So right now you see this one orange node. So the radius works in conjunction with this orange node. Right now you only see one little black spot. So if we go like this, the whole thing gets bigger. If you tap on radius and you see two, that means you can go like this and only that side gets bigger. You can go like this and this side gets small. If you use three, then you can make them all whatever size that you want. So, of course, we're making this little cone thing, so we'll shrink this down a little bit. We just want to use we can use the three or the two, because it doesn't matter if you know, we can always go like this, and then we can open this up a little bit. So, pretty useful. You can pretty much do anything that you want with the tube tool. It's very, very useful. Tails, even arms or legs, things like that. But I think this is pretty good for our little character. Maybe I'll put a little bit more of a bend in it. Maybe make it a little fatter. Something like that. And you can move these around too to sort of get the right angles and stuff, but you get it. So I think that's pretty good. I don't want to make the tops too sharp because I want to round them out. So once you're happy with your cone or your tube, you can hit validate just like anything else, and then they become their shape. But just remember to name them. So we're gonna go in the scene, go down here. They're already in the arms, which is the mirror. So they're already in there, so they're mirrored. So let's just rename them horns. Also, should be saving a lot. So let's go to this folder, save. And let's call this little dev. Okay, so we have that. He's saved. Save a lot, save often. I should have been saving more. All right, so yeah, he's looking pretty good. Everything looks good so far. I'm very happy with this little rascal. Okay, so next, I think we should start adding some of these little details, like the little fingers. And I guess we can start voxel remeshing this whole thing together. But let's add the fingers and toes and things like that. So let's start with the feet. So right now, this number, the spheres, is 6,146. So I want to use inflate, I think, to make the little toes. So if we use the inflate tool, we don't want symmetry. We still don't want symmetry, and we're on the foot. So if you go like this, you see that the little, we can make little toes fairly easily. And they actually don't look too bad for it only being very small. Some, if this number is too small, it will be hard to get details. So we did one, maybe even, I don't even think they need to be that big. But let's test it out and see if we can get three kind of next to each other that look good. And this is just like a very simple way to do feet. And I actually think it did a pretty good job just with the inflate tool. They do look a little funny to me, so I might use the gizmo and use this green ring to kind of like, so they're not so, I kind of made them duck-footed, which happens sometimes. But yeah, I think that looks a little bit better. He's not so duck-footed. And you can also use move. So now I'm gonna use move, and I just want to, you can just kind of adjust these little toes. As long as the move tool is fairly small, you can adjust the little toes and pull them out a little bit. But I think that looks good. I think I'm okay with that. So let's do the same thing with the arms. So we'll tap on the arms, we'll use inflate. And it's a little tricky, we have this base here. So if you wanna do the fingers like that, then you can just tap on the base, go to your scene, and just hide it. And then tap on the arm so you can go back to the arm. So he just has little tiny little fingers. You can make two or three fingers, you know, if you want. You can make a thumb if you want. I think the thumb would kind of be here. It feels right to me. Or maybe it'd be a little bit higher. But maybe I'll do three fingers. We did three toes, so maybe I'll just do three fingers. Or a thumb and two fingers. Kind of like that. I think that looks good. So, you know, feel free to use your inflate if you want to make the fingers a little bit bigger. Something like that. But honestly, I think that looks good. Let's bring back the platform and let's trim these feet. Did you see that? See the feet? Very bloated. So we'll tap on the feet. We'll tap on trim. And here are my trim settings. Just so you can see my trim settings, feel free to pause. I'm just gonna go through my settings if you wanna match anything. Whoops. So you can't hit any of these. So here's my settings. Okay. So now we're on trim, we're gonna use rectangle. Make sure you hit the feet. You wanna hit rectangle. And I'm just gonna draw a square like this, but only the white part is what will get trimmed. So I'm gonna bring this up a little bit lower than the toes. I don't wanna do right at the toes, but a little bit lower like that. And now you don't have to do this, but I just wanna show you the feet are trimmed. Okay, so now let's do the mouth. So there's lots of ways to do the mouth. I think we'll do mask. So we use the mask tool. Click on the face. We want to use symmetry. And when I scribble, you see how it's very like blurry. So I'm going to save. Let's hit it. Let's do a quick save. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to remesh this. Remeshing will add more geometry or take away geometry. So remeshing will add more geometry, which will in turn make this mesh more dense. Higher resolution, a higher density means higher details. If this number is lower, lower resolution, smaller file size, less details. I don't know what I just hit. Mask. So, for example, if you go up here, voxel, remesh at 153, it's not bad. So if I remesh at 153, okay, it's a little bit better. And again, I use the shortcut down here. I'm gonna undo. So now it's back to normal. I'm gonna voxel remesh 153. This is the same exact thing, but I'm gonna bring it up to 200 or 205 or whatever, and then remesh. Okay, it's not bad. We're going close. It's a little bit sharper. And I think that's good enough for us. Also, you notice there's all these little things, and that's because when we voxel remeshed, we raised the resolution. But the way that it does it sometimes is it'll split the pieces that are already there, and you'll wind up with this. So you can smooth it out. Just use this move tool and make it bigger, and you can kind of smooth all this out. It's a little bit different than the thing I showed you in the beginning, the smooth shading. It's a little bit different than that. See, it doesn't really make a difference. It's just when you voxel remesh versus those other things you can do, like you can raise the number before you voxel remesh and they'll go away, but that gets confusing. So I'll just leave you with voxel remesh for now. We'll also use that to voxel remesh everything together soon. So back to mask. So now we just need to make, we just need to make this mouth shape. You can make your mouth any shape that you want. I guess I'll try to stick to the thing. So this is where you need to utilize your drawing skills. You just need to make the mouth however you want it. Make sure this is at 100% opacity. So I'm going to make this smaller, and I just want to make the edges a little clearer. And it actually looks like the mouth is more like that shape. And it looks like it, sometimes it moves to like a different tool and you just completely get messed up. I hate when that happens. Okay. So that looks a little bit too big to me. So I'm going to use unmask. And you can kind of do the same thing. So you can kind of just shape it. Let me just make this a little bit smaller. I just want to shape this mouth. Okay, something like that, but it's a little more round. So, you know, take your time. As you can see, like it's a little tricky sometimes to do this. So it's just important to take your time until you get the shape you want, because you don't want to have to come back and do it. So I think that looks pretty good. Maybe it's a little wider on the sides. I'm kind of crazy with these kind of details. Even though this isn't really how I would make a mouth on my own, but okay, I think something like that is good. So you just want something similar to that. Is it too high? Is it too low? I don't know. I'll make it a little bit lower. A little bit lower on the top. Like I said, I'm kind of crazy with details like that. So if I look at the front, so I'm looking at the space between the side of the mouth and there. Looks okay. I can probably make this a little wider. And looking at space between this and the top of the head, because we still have to put this weird little nose thing and the weird little eyes. But I think that looks good. So now we're in the mask options up here. Oh, if you notice, you can do that as well. So we're in the mask. We're in the mask options. Invert. So this is just going to invert what we've done. There you go. So now the only active part is this part that's unmasked. So it's not protected. So now we can use the gizmo, and if we use these gizmo, it'll only move the parts that are not protected. So we can move this in. So we'll just move it in like that. Maybe even make it a little bit bigger, you know, or smaller, whatever you want. So we move that in, and it's a little bit alarming because you see this other shape but that's just the body. So let's go to the body. We'll do trim. And let's do lasso. So we'll take the lasso. The lasso is just like a freestyle trim thing. And if we look like on the side, we can kind of see where the mouth is. So remember, you're on the body part, you're on lasso. So I'm just gonna lasso this shape. We're gonna go like this, right above where that body is, and make a big circle like that. And then it's just gonna cut it and get rid of it. So now this is the back part of the mouth that we're seeing. It's not the body. So the body is trimmed below the head now. Okay, so that's pretty much all we have to do for this part. So let's go back to the mask tools and hit clear. Whoop, must not be on the head. Yep, there we go. Mask, clear. So there we go. So now we have the inside of the mouth. So let's save our progress. So at this point, let's see, the horns look pretty good. Everything looks pretty good. Oh, there's supposed to be a tail too. So let's make a little tail. Let's add a sphere. Yeah, let's add a sphere. We'll use our gizmo. We'll move it out this way and up a little bit. And then let's shrink it. So maybe something like that. So remember, we have to validate it, and then we can use move. But first, let's name it so we don't get confused. Name, tail. Okay, let's look at our number. 175K, not too bad. We'll shrink it up a little bit later on. So we'll use move. Make sure you're on the tail. You want to turn symmetry on. So let's just make a tail. We can't really see what his tail looks like. So let's just start by just kind of stretching this out. I think a little bit like this. Maybe we'll stretch this part up. Stretch it into the body like that. Maybe we can kind of flatten it out. So I think something like that looks pretty good for a little tail. But you can make it any shape you want. Maybe you want it a little bit puffier, or pudgier. Like that. You can do that too. Maybe it's even like a little bit of like a round tail. But what I like to do is, if something is sitting on the ground, then I like to kind of spread it out like on the ground and then trim it. Because that will make it look like that the weight is like on the ground. Maybe I'll stretch it out a little bit more. I think I want a little bit wider at the base. Okay, how is that? It's okay. I think I want it a little bit shorter, so I'm just going to use the gizmo and just shrink it. And I think I want to use flatten. Flatten's a great tool. You just use symmetry. And maybe I want to flatten the top. So you can just kind of flatten it. Another great use of the tools. And maybe we want to add, like, let's say on the body, we want to continue this line. You can do something like crease. And then if, as long as you're on the body, you can like make a crease. Like, well, actually we want to do a reverse. So hit sub and it's a reverse crease. So you can do something like that. So then when we box where we mesh them together, it'll sort of look like, even on the tail, you can do crease, the inverse crease. You can go like that. So once we mesh these two, we can smooth them out. And it'll just look like one little thing. But also you can do things like this too. You can take inflate. We'll make it small. And maybe on the tail you want like some little, you know, some little things like that. You can do that. But those might be better after we box where we mesh them together. Because like I was saying before, see how these aren't very clear? We might have to box where we mesh them. Actually, let's just do it. Let's voxel remesh this tail at 175. There we go. So now if we were to do something like that, they'd be a little bit better. Maybe I'll double them up. Maybe we'll do one on the back. Let's voxel remesh the back too. We'll do it at 175 as well. So we'll remesh the back. So now if we want to add those little thingies, we can do that as well. But don't be afraid to add like little details like that. I mean, why not? I'll make them a little bit longer. So when we smooth these will smooth down a little bit. So yeah, so anyway, this is looking pretty good. Let's add some time. We got 51 minutes. So let's see what we can do in 10 minutes. So now let's add some teeth. So for the teeth, they're very squarish. So let's see. So let's add, we're gonna use a box. So let's go to Gizmo and let's bring the box up and let's bring the box forward and then let's just shrink it so it's more toothy shaped. Let's use this blue ring and squish it like that. So now we have something like this. But what we need to do is make it more round, because right now it's too boxy. So let's take our square and validate it. So I'm gonna hit validate and let's use smooth symmetry and let's smooth off the sides. And you see how like it's very soft. So let's hit undo, and there's a few things that we can do. You can make a round edge brush, but if you want to make this, check out my Nomad Sculpt cheat sheet. It's an easy way to make this tool that would make it much easier, but I don't want to go into too much in this video. So let's just go to symmetry and turn on Y and Z. So now let's just make this a little bit bigger and very softly just kind of go, wrong tool. Use the smooth tool and just kind of smooth out your square. Just try to go along the edges fairly evenly. So something like that. Easy peasy. So let's go back into symmetry and turn these two off. We'll just leave the default red one on. So now we have generally our tooth, but right now it's called a box. So let's just name it teeth. Okay, so now we have one tooth. We need to make it a mirror. So the front teeth can be like more like teeth. Add mirror. So now teethies are in a mirror. I'm gonna rename the mirror itself teeth. So you wanna tap on the teeth, tap on the gizmo, and now we can kind of move these apart like this. And let's go ahead and shrink them a little bit more. Let's bring them into place, or put them more into place inside the mouth. Okay, that looks good. So now we can sort of figure out, we can put them a little closer, and maybe we want to angle them using this green just to make them a little bit more ergonomic. So maybe we'll put them together a little bit more because they're pretty close in the art, in the AI art. Okay, so that looks good. So I'm gonna take smooth, and I just wanna smooth off the ends a little bit more. Okay. So now what we can do is we can just clone these teeth. So we'll hit clone, and then we can use the gizmo, and then we can just easily make other teeth. So now we have two new teeth. So I think what we'll do is use the green ring to kind of angle them back, and then we just put them back in the mouth like this. And we can take a look at the drawing. So they look like they're a little bit more kind of round here. So I'm just going to take a move tool and I'm just going to move this down a little bit, and maybe even a little bit with these. But with these, I'm going to turn off symmetry because I just want the insides just make it a little round. Just give it a little bit of shape, like that. Okay, so also, let's make this one a little bit smaller because he has the bottom teeth too. So let's make this a little smaller. We'll bring it back in. Let's bring it up a little bit. That looks a little bit more accurate. So then we'll just move these teeth, and just sort of, you know, maybe even, I might even tilt them a little bit. Okay, so that looks good. I'm gonna go ahead and clone these again. So now we have three pair, and I might just put another pair back behind these. Maybe I'll make it a little bit smaller. Angle it a little bit. Notice how I move the canvas around. Whoops, wrong arrow. And you'll get used to the gizmo. It's a little tricky at first, but you'll get used to it. So maybe something like that. Although this looks like it's down a little bit further. And these teeth actually look like they're down a little bit further. You know what I want to do? I think I want to angle these even more. I think that's what I want to do. I want to angle them even more and then angle this one even more and bring them closer. So it looks like more of like an arch. But I just have to make sure they're not like connecting. Teeth aren't showing through. So that looks pretty good. I think that looks pretty good. So now I'm going to go back to these teeth. And I'm going to clone them and move them down. So I'll move them down and maybe I'll move them out a little bit. Maybe open them up that way a little bit. I'm going to shrink them this way. So that looks pretty good. Same process. I'm going to clone these. Move these guys over and just make, you know, that the nice little row of teeth. So take your time with this. You know, I'm a little bit used to the gizmo, so it's hard for me to do it slowly, but you'll get used to using the gimbo, you'll get used to using the gizmo, but it's a little tricky at first. It just takes some getting used to. It can be a bit annoying sometimes. So maybe I'll angle these a little bit more. And maybe I'll add another little thing of teeth. Maybe I'll clone again. Maybe not though. I don't know if I want to keep another row of teeth. Maybe I'll shrink them. A little bit more maybe. Yeah, maybe I'll do something like that. That looks okay. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. I think it looks great. So now what I want to do is... Oh, let's see. Yeah, I think all the teeth look pretty good, actually. I don't think we need to do anything more with those. So let's just take all the teeth and validate. Yes. So now we just have the teeth. Okay, great. And if we want to add a tongue, let's add a sphere. We'll use our gizmo. Let's bring it all the way up so we can see it. And we'll just shrink it this way, flatten it out. And we might not need to do anything more. We'll just bring it down. Maybe we'll shrink it a little bit more, flatten it a little bit more. Bring it out forward, and it's a pretty decent tongue. So let's validate it. Move. So now with the move tool, let's turn symmetry on, and you know, if you want, you can maybe puff it up a little bit if you want, make it a little more tongue-like, but something like that. Maybe bring it forward a little bit. And if you want to get really crazy, we can touch the head part. We can use layer. Layer is great. We're going to use sub. Make sure symmetry is on. So make sure that you touch the head part. And then what you can do is just make like a depression behind the tongue. It doesn't have to be that big, maybe a little smaller, like that. And you can lift up and then touch it, do the same thing again. It'll just go a little bit deeper. So now we'll just take the smooth tool and kind of smooth that out back there. So now it kind of looks like there's like, you know, the back of the mouth, like the tongue is going and there's a throat. So let's save. Okay, great. So next, I think we'll just Vox remesh all this stuff together. So, okay, so we have all the arms and the heads and the horns. Everything's looking good. Let's go ahead and validate. So select all of these, make sure you select the red part last, and then hit validate, join children. And I think all of this should voxel remesh pretty nicely, but we'll see. So now, let's go ahead and take the head, the sphere. Let's see, what is the sphere? Oh, the sphere is the tongue. So let's leave that. That's what happens when you don't label things. The tail, the arms, the body. So we want these four, and we'll voxel remesh them. Let's do it at like 300. So let's remesh at 300. Now everything's together. We can take a look and just make sure that it looks right. It looks okay. I think it looks okay. So now we can take smooth. Make sure you have symmetry on, and then you can smooth out everything. So you smooth everything together. And before you do the fingers and the toes, I'm gonna do it a little bit, but that's where you wanna make sure that you're very careful. So for example, on the back, I don't mind kind of just smoothing willy-nilly, but on the front, I wanna make sure that I'm very careful because I don't wanna ruin the toe detail or that finger detail. So I'm going to very softly here. Belly, you can kind of do willy-nilly. Just be careful when you get to the toes. Also here, this is okay to smooth out that mouth. Might have to adjust the teeth a little bit, but it looks pretty good so far. Okay, yeah, the teeth look pretty good. If you want to make, I kind of want to bend the front teeth out, so I'm just going to use move. I tap on the teeth part, and let's see if I can use move to just kind of move these out a little bit. Turn symmetry off. Just try to, oh no, I can't. Turn symmetry back on. Just try to move them out a little bit. And we didn't voxel remesh them together, so that's why we can kind of move them around, you know, sort of like independent of all the other teeth. Okay, I think that looks better. Okay, so now we're doing pretty well. I just want to use crease and try to make this a little bit more creasy. So let's use crease. We don't want sub, so we turn that off. So now I'm just going to trace here. Whoops. Make sure you tap the body. So I just want to trace here and then kind of trace up the arm like so, just to give it a little bit more separation. Okay, I think everything else looks good. And remember, we used crease before. Actually, let's smooth out this little section here. These little things got a little funny looking. Yeah, they got real funny looking, actually. Let's see, what do we want to do with those? Maybe we'll use flatten. What happens when you flatten out the tips? I think that might look a little bit better, actually. I don't mind that. just a little detail. Okay, so also, let's make sure that we trim this part of the tail because of that it's going below. So we want to use trim. I'm going to make sure I tap left. We're on the body. So I just want to, let's use the rectangle. I just want to make sure I'm trimming the tail right below where the tail is. There we go. Good. Okay, so now let's do these eyes. So I think the way I want to do the eyes is, how do I want to do the eyes? Okay, I think I have, I think I have an idea. So let's use clay and let's see, what do I want to do here? I'm going to do it a little bit different than the drawing. Let me pause this because I've already recorded over an hour. So let me pause this and come back. Okay, so we're just going to do the little eyes and the nostrils, and we'll do some lighting, and we'll pretty much wrap this little guy up. So now let's, so he has like little, these little sort of button type eyes. I think the easiest thing to do would be to, so we have the body here. Also make sure you're saving a lot. So let's add, we'll add a sphere. We'll use our gizmo to bring it up. And we're gonna use these as these little different colored eyes. So I'm gonna tap gizmo and hit mirror. Then I'm gonna hit gizmo again and we can break these apart, shrink them. And this is where it kind of gets fun because you'll see a lot of characters that you might want to make as you're making this one. You'll see like a lot of places you can put the eyes, a lot of different, you know, it's, there's so much to where you put two spheres on a head that will really make your character look different, you know? So it's just, that's what's really fun for me. So I think this actually might be decent. So I think that's pretty decent. So I'm gonna, I guess I can leave it on a line. So once you have the place where you kind of want the eyes, I'm gonna turn it on its side and use this blue to kind of go like this. I know that seems counterintuitive, but now I'm gonna use the ring and let's actually take it off of a line so you can sort of see the trajectory of the sphere. So now when I bring it out, see how it's kind of like this? I just wanted them flatter so they're not like big round spheres. So now all I have to do is use the rings until it just kind of looks like it's on the surface of the head. So that's all I was really going for. I just wanted them to look like they're on the surface of the head. So I'm just gonna kind of continue to tilt a little bit until they look pretty even. That looks pretty good. I still don't feel completely even, so you might just have to take a look at a few different angles and, you know, kind of just adjust them a little bit until they look clear. I think that looks pretty good. They might be a little big. I'm gonna make them a little smaller. Maybe move them apart a little bit. Yeah, I think that looks pretty good. So I think that looks perfect. So I'm gonna go ahead and label this eyes. I'll label this eyes too. Just always good to label everything. So I'm happy with those. I'm gonna leave those. We can validate. So I'm gonna tap on the orange eyes and then just validate. So now we have the two eyes, but they're still in the mirror. So, you know, we can still move them around if we needed to. So there's also these two little marks there. So I think I want to use tube for that. So I'll use tube and let's use curve since we haven't used it. And let's use snap. Snap just means that it'll snap to whatever the surface is. So if I make a curve and go like this, it's going to stick to the surface. So that's all that is. But what we're going to do is just make this little arch. So it's sort of like this, but I'm gonna do a little something extra on the side of mine. So I'm gonna do mine a little bit like that. I'm gonna hit spline, see how it's not curvy? I'm gonna hit spline. So then it's nice and curvy. And you can kind of make it, you know, shape it as much as you want, maybe something like that. Maybe a little bit more of an arch. Okay, and mine looks a little bit, you know what? I think I'm just gonna do a little arch in the middle of the eye instead. So, really easy, I'm just gonna adjust these things until they're, you know, where I want them to be. And just make your little arch inside. That looks pretty good, but I think I wanna make this part a little bit lower. I think that looks a little bit better. Okay, so now to make this little arch, both sides are small, both ends, and the middle is a little bit bigger. So I think in order to do that, we'll hit radius twice. Remember, so now we can do the ends a little bit small, oops, we can do the ends a little bit smaller, and then we can make the inner part a little bit bigger. So we can do something like that. And we can also, if we want to make this part flat, we can use the profile. So we tap on profile and see this box profile. So that way it already, you see it already changed into kind of a flatter box shape, which I think looks pretty good actually. Yeah, I actually like that. I think that might work. But I don't think I need it too thick. So you can just adjust the thickness to how you want it. I think that looks great. So I'm gonna just validate it. And I really like it, so I'm gonna voxel remesh it because right now it's really, the number's really low, so it's really soft. So what I wanna do is just do a voxel remesh, maybe at like 150. You see it kind of changes kind of solidifies it a little bit. I'll use symmetry, we don't need symmetry. So I'm just gonna smooth it out a little bit. Something like that. I think it's perfect. So now there's this little piece here, which I'm not even really sure what I want to do with that. If I want to do a little nose type thing like that. But there are some options. Like if you can always use layer, really tiny, hit symmetry, make sure you're on the head. You know, you can just do like maybe little nostrils like this. I think that looks better than like whatever that is. So you can do something like that. You can use crease. Where's crease? You can use crease too. And just do like kind of like two little creasy nostrils, which I think also look good. You can adjust different positions of those. I can also just put no nose. I'd be okay with that too. Oh, here's another little trick. You can use inflate or clay or whatever you want. You can go on the body and you could do something like this too. Just make sure you don't make them like look too mean by accident. You can add a little something like that. You can use drag too and you can like, you know, you can really accentuate. Maybe even flatten, and you can like flatten this out a little bit. Things like that. I like it. I love it. Okay, so let's save. Let's just do some quick lighting. So let's take it off of lit PBR. So let's go back here. We'll change from Metcap back to lit PBR. Now it's all white, which I hate. So I'm gonna take everything and change it to, I guess I should make it this color. Let's make this blue. Let's make it like a light blue, like the art. So we'll make it something like that. Roughness, I like to be about 0.6. So we'll do that. This, we can make it sort of the same color. Let's bring it up to like a reddish. Maybe it's more like orangish. Let's see. Can I move this? Oh, I can move this. That's very useful. Very useful. So now let's try to match that color. It does look more reddish. I think maybe it's around there. Maybe a little more. Yeah, maybe something like that. Looks good. Give me the roughness down a little bit. So it looks a little plasticky. So maybe somewhere around there, we'll do paint all. And in case you missed it, you just touch this to bring that up. This little ball right here. Teeth look pretty good, but let's make them a little bit. Let's go to a little bit orangey. Let's go to it a little bit off-white with the teeth. See, this is white. We'll go a little bit off-white. That. And let's tap on the ball. Let's tap the little eyedropper. Hold it over this. So make sure you're on that part of the eye. And let's just make that a lighter version of this. So we'll make it like a lighter version. Paint all. Actually, it looks like more of a cream color, if I'm honest. So maybe we'll do it more of a cream color, like so. Now let's tap on the little eye parts, and we can do those a matte black. So we'll go to black and bring the roughness up. We don't want any sort of glare or anything like that. I think that's good. And this tongue, you can make whatever color because he doesn't actually have it. So I think I'm going to do like a, blue tongue. Because I can. Okay, so that looks pretty good. So let's save our colors. So now I think we should just add some lighting. Really easy lighting. So first let's tap on this little lighting thing right here. Actually, we can turn off the, let's turn this off. So we'll tap here and just turn off the reference image. You can change the background to whatever color you want by going here. So now let's go here. This is my personal environment. I usually use that to light all my, you can't really, if I had like big eyes, you could see this shape in the eyes and it looks great, but there's not really much in this scene. But if you want this, just go to my website and just look for the environment. Download. I think there's a picture of an eye on it. But we're going to turn this off. So it should be just completely black. I'm going to hit front. Let's go here and change it to perspective. Let's put the perspective down to like 10 something. And now we'll just go to this little light and we'll just add a light. So that's going to be our key light. So let's tap the little pencil key. Tap the three dots, softness. I like a good soft shadow. Let's turn this up to like maybe around 2, or maybe a little bit higher, maybe 2.5. So that'll be our key light. So now let's clone this, and this will, let's rename it fill, F-I-L-L. This will be our fill light. So we'll move this over and use the green ring to bring it towards our little character here. Fill in those shadows, take the intensity and put the intensity down. See, we just don't want it black. We want to just fill those shadows in a little bit. So now we will clone this and we'll name this one Rim. This is going to be our rim light. So we like this, we like where our character is. So let's tap on the little camera, hit add view, and let's name it 1. So now we have our camera view. So we'll go back to our light, We'll tap on the rim. So now let's take a look at this. So let's turn him this way. This is our light. This is the rim light. So see, I'm springing it here. It actually doesn't matter that I'm moving it here for the sun, because the sun doesn't matter where the light is. All that matters is the angle. But we're going to change it to a spotlight. See, so now it's a spotlight. So now you have to aim this at the character. So you want to aim it right around there. There you go. See how it's like shining on him? Kind of like the back side. So we want to raise the intensity of this. And we want to change this orange to open it up a little bit more. So now when we go to our camera and we go to one, then we have our view and you see this wonderful rim light or edge light that's just lighting this little edge here. It doesn't have to be too bright. So maybe that's good. Okay, so that's great. So now we're going to clone this light, name it TD. So this will be our top down light. So let's just use the arrows and move this right over top of them. Move it up. Then use the rings. Whoops. Find the right ring and then rotate it right over his head. So something like this. Move it up a little bit more maybe. And maybe I'll use this orange to kind of narrow it out a little bit. So let's maybe up a little bit more. So I think that's pretty good. I like to put a little bit of a cool light on this. So I'm going to tap this. Bring this over so it's a little richer, little richer, and bring that up to like a blue color. Okay. And then maybe the rim light I'll make a little bit warmer. Something like that. Maybe the fill light too. You can go to the fill light, maybe make that a little warmer as well. So then you have a little bit of warm light on that side and a little bit of a cool light on that other side. All right, I think that looks great. So let's go ahead and turn our environment on, but let's turn the exposure down to like 1.3 or so, maybe even lower. Yeah, maybe like 1.2, something like that. So let's press our camera. Let's hit a quick save. So now let's go to this. This is post-processing. So post-processing is really what your sculpt will look like. That's when it does all the mathematics of the lighting and the shadows and things like that. So we'll hit post process. You have a better look. You can play with these things, can raise it up. This is when it can be a little bit taxing on the system. So just be aware of that. And you can play around with these options. Ambient occlusion is sort of like all of the little shadows and things, makes the shadows a little bit more. And, you know, so play around with all of that. Depth of field is just like it sounds. If you have something in the background and you want it blurry, you turn this on, and then things further away will be more blurry with this. Bloom has to do with light, and it kind of, if you have like a bright light, it'll sort of like make it a little more glowy. See what it's doing to the light? So like that's bloom. So you can play around with all these. These are pretty fun. So now that we have this post-processing on, the system's going to be a little laggy, but now is a good time to adjust the lights a little bit more. So I'm going to bring the exposure down a little bit. And I like to sometimes just go through my lights and just make sure that they still look good and that they're doing what they're supposed to be doing. So TD, I'm going to make it a bit bluer and I'm going to lower the intensity a little bit. Okay, let's take a look without the key. Key might be a little bright, so I'm going to lower the intensity just a smidge. Okay, so and one thing that we want to do for the body is go here and then make it subsurface and then bring the depth down to maybe like 0.1 or so. So we're going to do that to the eyes as well, which... Let's take the tube, let's take it out of this and let's rename it lash. So these are the lashes. So we rename it, but just hit add and then hit mirror so that it's in its own mirror. And now we can tap on both of those. Make sure you tap on the red one second and validate it. We have to rename it lashes or lashes, whatever you want to call them. Eyes, we can do the same thing. We can validate them. And now we just have the eyes. And let's save our progress. So now let's do the same thing. Tap on the eyes and tap on this little circle and subsurface. Bring the depth down a little bit. I want to do the same with the teeth. Subsurface, bring it down a little bit. And the tongue might be okay. I think I might just leave the tongue. So let's go back to post-process. Just make sure everything is looking good. Everything is how you want it to look. You can adjust all this stuff. I think it looks great. Yeah, I think it looks good. So there's your little character. Just go through and adjust the lights as you wish. You may want to bring this, maybe make this more intense. You could bring it a little bit far behind. And if you adjust the subsurface, you can actually see through the skin and things like that. So for example, on the skin, if you want to raise this up a little bit, you'll be able to see through the skin a little bit more. See how it's kind of reddish there? So that's pretty fun too. And also, let's say for the teeth, if we go here, if you want to change this to maybe something a little bit more yellow. So that just means like that as much as you can see through the teeth, which you can't really see through too much now, but it would be yellow instead of this like red that's like inside there. Let's try it without the environment. I think it actually looks, I think I actually like it with the environment. And definitely play with your lights a lot because sometimes you can get some really cool effects with your lights that you might not be thinking about. Like I might leave the fill off actually. I might take TD. I might bring this over here and shine it this way. Bring the intensity up. Maybe something like this. Wider. Hit it from there. Maybe take the key, turn it down a little bit. So there's lots of things you can do, but ultimately I think I'm pretty happy with this guy. I'll probably export him to Blender. Whoops. Let's take a look at him in the front. Here we go. There's our little character. So now let's hit view. We gotta make all this stuff go away. Sometimes I just hit select, so all these things goes away. You can turn the light icons off right here. So you can kind of just see your character. I think he looks good. Let's make the lighting a little more dynamic by turning the background color down. Kind of makes it a little bit more exciting. But yeah, there's our little character. Hopefully you had fun. Hopefully you learned a lot. I think I will bring this guy into Blender. Just to see how he looks over there. I think he'll look good. And two more things before you go. There's a thing called decimation. So right now our scene vertices is 345K, which is kind of high. And a lot of these pieces are a bit high. So if I tap on the teeth, it's 43. What you do is you go here, go to misc, and decimate. So this is like the opposite of voxel remeshing higher. Decimating will just lower the polygon count. You just have to be careful. You don't want to do it too much or it will change the surface area of where you're doing. So right now we're on the teeth. So if I hit it once, you really don't see a difference. If I hit it twice, you really don't see a difference and we save some space. So now I'm just going to go through, decimate that once maybe. You don't see a difference. 36K. I'll go back here to misc, decimate. decimate, decimate, you don't really see any difference. So we're just saving space. For the body, 228K, we go here and decimate 50%. Now it's 114. Really don't see too much of a difference. So you can keep it, or if you need more space, you can decimate it again. And it still looks pretty good. I think I might have seen a little change. So I'm gonna go back one and just leave it there. I think the tongue is pretty small. I guess I can decimate it once. This is 19K, so maybe I can decimate this as well, but that's just the platform. But now it's 148K, so it's a lot smaller. So that's just how you can save some space with it. So let's go ahead and save our little character now. He's a lot smaller, and this might actually be really cool as a print as well. So to export, you would just go here, make sure that you have it saved, and also make sure that your bells and whistles are all the way up here. So you go to the little folder thing, scroll all the way down to the bottom to render, and you can do 4K, you can do 1080, you know, whatever you'd like to do. I want to do 4K. Just make sure that it's framed upright. So you might have to make it a little smaller. Oh, and if you have depth of field on, just make sure that you've tapped where you want the depth of field to go. So I'm just gonna turn it off so I don't have to worry about it. So we'll go here, 4K, it's framed nicely. So now I'll just export this. Okay, and then it'll export to the computer. All right, and that's about it. Hopefully that was useful. I had a lot of fun. That was longer than expected, but sometimes even simple characters can wind up being a little bit long. So, you know, that's just how it is. But hopefully you learned a lot. Let me know in the comments. Let me know what you think. And there will be lots more to come because I love making these. So if you like them, then definitely like the video. It's very important that you like the video and leave a comment too. Sometimes I try to respond to all I can, but I do see all the comments, so and I appreciate each and every one of them. So keep drawing, keep sculpting. I'll see you guys in the next video.